October the 18th.
Good morning, everyone. Today marks the day of my 1 year anniversary being on Mounjaro. And I'm gonna wear this bead seed necklace here. Maybe. And yeah, I got my little raccoon buddy on, and I've got to go to the post office and drop some things off. And I did pick up two more hoodies yesterday. I'll show y'all that real quick. Okay, so I found this one. This is the back of it at my local Burlington. And this is the back of this one. Found it at my local Burlington. It's got Marie the cat on it. It's actually the one I'm gonna wear today. Today is early voting day. Started yesterday, and me and my husband are gonna go do that later when he gets back from his office stuff that he's got going on. But it's pretty nippy outside. In fact, it is 46 degrees. Can y'all see that? So I am zipping up. Where's my phone? There it is. I washed these yesterday when I got home with them. But yeah. Marie, Marie, Marie. I love Marie the cat. I cannot believe I found these. They had all sizes too. But yeah, it's cute. But yeah, that y'all saw my weight this morning. I think the lowest that I've been since being on Mounjaro, let me move y'all up a minute, it has been around 156. I have to go back and look. I think it was like 156. So I was surprised that it was 157. I actually jumped on there twice, 157.1. I jumped on there twice just to make sure. And let's see. I'm trying to think. So I kept bumping up in poundage. It was like 3 or 4, 5 pounds. And then I go down, then I go up, then I go down. And I was like, dang, every time I get ready to share it with y'all, it was like nothing had changed. So I didn't really feel like putting that in every single video. That's why there has been a little lapse on any kind of weight loss. But I just thought, well, I'll just tell them what's been going on. And so that's what I had stated in, like, what was it, the video before the last one? Yeah, I think I stated it then. But now that it's gone down, I need to adjust my little knot. I put a little knots in my thing here so it wouldn't get, you know, come out in the washing machine, because that does it to me all the time. And I don't have it. I need to bring it up higher. But I'm happy with my weight loss. I would like to get to at least 140. Maybe 145. I'm not really that far off. And the thing is I haven't been trying. This whole journey, I don't feel like I've tried. Oh yeah, I don't feel like I've tried during this journey like I could have. I've just let the shot do its work. I was walking more initially, and I haven't done that. And now I feel like, dang, it's going to be getting real cold here soon, and I'm not going to want to be freezing my butt off out there. But Jennifer's going to be going out there, because then we'll have sweatpants and layered up and all that kind of stuff going on. So, and y'all are coming with me when I do that. We'll be right back into doing that. Other than, you know, I walk at work. Y'all know that. But, yeah, this has been a big change for where I was this time last year. I mean, I was a big monster. I mean, like, my weight was just taking over my life, my mood, any of the happiness that I tried to have for other things. It was, the weight was always there. How I looked in the mirror and stuff like that. And every time I get ready to get in the shower and I go and look in the mirror and I'm like, I can't believe that's me. I can see it now. Whereas opposed before, I really couldn't see it. Now I do forget a lot of times that Jennifer, you can wear an large now. And in fact, some things you can wear a medium in. But I don't always buy a large or a medium or anything. I'm still hanging on to fat girl clothes in my mind. Like, you need to, you know, you better get the size you know you're supposed to be in. Well, I'm not in that size no more. So, if you haven't got there yet, hang in there. You will get there. It's just, you know, it's not a race. So just take it one day at a time. That's all I've done, is take it one day at a time. And I'm just trying to encourage myself as well as you guys that just because you have a stalling weight loss, that doesn't mean it's over. That's just your body is trying to adjust and adapt. And I had to, you know, tell myself that. I have to preach that to myself. And I don't want to hear that. I want to see results like anybody else would. But slow down, take your time, and get your mind on something else, because before you know it, you're going to get on the scale and be like, what? When did that happen? Because that's what happened to me a minute ago. That's why I had to jump on there twice. So, good morning, everyone. Happy Saturday. I am in extra layers today because it's like, well, it says 38 there. My watch says 40. But it's colder than a mother bear because mother bears are cold. Got me some cold coffee, though, so that's really weird. Had Chinese food last night, and I'm kind of scared about eating my leftovers today because something tore my stomach up yesterday like nobody's business. I just wanted to die. And I brought the leftovers only because I think that the culprit I thought about it this morning when I was in the shower, may have been what I bought at TJ Maxx like the day before, which was a bag of, there were these little, you know how they have snacks and stuff in TJ Maxx if you've ever been in there, these little what they call waffle cones that they're topped with chocolate on the inside, and then in there it had underneath the chocolate pistachio cream, and it just looked intriguing to me, and it was marked down with a red clearance sticker for $4, and I thought, let me try that because I love myself some pistachios. And the thing was, is two of them little jokers, which were no bigger than that, is 100 calories. I was like, what? Because, and there was 12 all together in that bag, 12 of them things. And I ate most of them and zipped up the bag. And then the next morning, yesterday morning, I was like, I'm gonna eat some more of them. So I opened up the bag, and apparently I only had one left in the bag. I had zipped up the bag without looking to see how many was in there, and zipped up and saved one of those things. So that was what my breakfast was. And now the vacuum's going. Okay, so I had to wait till the vacuum quit for a minute, but y'all, I've been keeping a secret. I was about to be in a movie over here in the Charlotte area. The movie is called Apopka. And I was going to be, it's based on a true story, and it's takes place in Daytona Beach, Florida. And if you're not familiar, I'm from Florida, but in the 90s is when it takes place, and it's about a woman boxer. And I was going to be a fight attendee, was my spot in the movie. But the thing was, is we were doing casting, the scenes were being done this past Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and I was supposed to be there on Wednesday. And there's the vacuum again. Maybe it's not too loud for y'all, but I was supposed to be there at 8 o'clock that morning. I drove all the way because it was going by your last name. So with me, mine was 8, and other people 8:30, and then there was 9. And so I let them know, look, I'm not going to be able to make it over there at 8 o'clock. And they're like, well, can you do 9? I said, well, it's possible, because I was like, I'll have to leave my house at 7:10 to make it over there. in time. But my husband said traffic right there in the middle of Charlotte where they've got me going is super duper bad. And I was afraid I would be late because you can't be late. That means I would have had to take Levi to school early. And I'm not even sure what time they accept kids coming into school because he rides the bus. So I never really thought about it before. And so I just told them to just replace me for now, you know. But they were definitely interested in everything. And I had already got set up for getting my pay. It was a RABS system that they use for paying you. And they basically wanted me to come hair and makeup ready, which means don't put anything on my face and do my hair. Yeah, is she getting closer with that vacuum? She's right outside the door. But I would have to take my nails off. And y'all, these nails have still been rocking on for like 2.5-3 weeks. I actually just got complimented by the lady when I was getting Chinese food yesterday. She said, "I like your nails." And I said, "Me too," because they're staying on. But I've been thinking about changing them out, and I just hadn't done it yet. But anyway, back to the movie situation. They're also filming a Channing Tatum. Gosh, I can't even talk. Movie. It's called Roof Man. It's based on a true story as well. I was going to apply for that, but I didn't. But this particular site, so I found out about it through our local news, and then they have a link for you to go to, and that's how I got connected with all that. And then I got connected with another link that lets me know when they're going to be shooting more movies and stuff in this area and need actors, actresses, or extras or whatever. So y'all might be seeing me in the movies at some point. And you almost got to see me in this one. I was so excited about it. But I didn't say nothing to y'all because, you know, when things fall through, like basically that, if I would have had a babysitter or something like that that could have come over, or, you know, had family in the close nearby proximity, I would have done it. My husband was out of town, so he couldn't come stay with the kids or do anything like that. But there's the vacuum again. But anyway, I've seen some of y'all was already asking questions on my video that went up this morning, so I'm gonna jump off here and answer some of that, and then I will pop back on here in a little while. Okay, I think the vacuuming has ceased for the moment. So remember the whole get that out of the way, the whole issue with the Coach Rowan purse. Okay, so the reason I had sent the other one back, or took the other one back rather, and got the bigger one, was because I felt like, you know, I wanted that bigger one. But I just wasn't happy with the darkness of the color of the bag. And y'all, then you've heard of buyer's remorse. Then I had returner's remorse. Like, why did I take that back? I should have kept it. But I decided to reorder a different bag. It was the size of the one previous. Instead of ordering that big one again, I just went ahead and ordered one that I thought was gone, because it's off the Coach website right now. I believe it's the one they had just prior to the release of the Rowans of late, because this one's actually got feet on it, but yet it's the medium size. But it's identical to the one I returned, other than the handles and the crossbody strap is the color of like a taupe, like an off-white color. But everything else is the same, where it's like the light khaki, and then on the ends it has the regular darker khaki on the ends, but it's gold hardware. So I ordered it. I actually found it on Walmart's website for very cheap. Like, when I say very cheap, it's about a dollar cheaper than what the Coach had at the time when I got the first time. They had a thing where if you signed up for their email, you got a discount, and it brought it down with tax and everything to like $139 or something. And I got it for this one with tax and everything. It was like $129, I think it is. Or no, it was $129. I think with all the tax and everything else, it was like $138. Maybe that's what it was. But I decided to go ahead and order that. And this one actually has feet on it,
Now the zipper's on the back side, like the new ones are, because I don't prefer to have the zipper pocket underneath the label, the pin label. You know what I'm talking about, like where it says Coach. I don't care for that style with that on there. I just think it looks tacky. And if you have one, I'm sorry. That's just my opinion for me. That's just me. I just feel like tacky may have been too harsh to say. I just feel like it shows like there's too much going on. There's too much detail on one side. I prefer the way they're doing it now, but I don't despise the feet on the bottom. I really don't have to have a bag with feet on the bottom anyway, because a lot of people say, oh, that helps keep your bag from getting dirty. Well, does it? Because if you take one of these out, lay it on the table like this, and then take some water on your hand and rub it on the bottom of your purse and then sit it on this, guess what's gonna happen? When you pick your purse up, this is gonna come with it because it's stuck to the bottom of it. It doesn't keep it from getting dirty like everybody thinks, because I've had lots of feet on purses that stuff still gets on there. So I feel like it's more of a stability situation. Like it helps keep your bag more, keeping its shape. So that whole, oh, we got feet. You're going to have platform shoes on the bottom of your purse to keep it from getting dirty. Am I right? So show me a bag that doesn't get dirty if you sit it down in chocolate syrup and then pull it back up and look at it. Show me that bag, because I will pay you some money, because I don't believe it. Now I'm getting on a preacher tangent here. I ain't had my glasses on all day at all. So I do know I want to get the lenses cleaned before I go out and to do a patrol. But it's colder than a mother bear. It's only 41 degrees. It's only went up a couple degrees since I was talking to y'all last. But anyway, I did want to pop that on there and in here and say that. So I'll show y'all a clip of what the purse, or a picture. I'll put a picture right here and show you what that purse looks like. And it should be here this coming Friday, the 25th. And so technically, I usually edit my videos anywhere between Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. So I may not be able to show you that bag until the next video after this one. So I apologize. But I need to set a reminder for myself to do some measurements of my waist and all that, you know, all your body parts, so I can compare what my first measurements was for y'all, because I want to do that for y'all. I did want to put together some kind of like something to do with a bunch of pictures that I've taken, but I've got to go through those pictures because I've got some that are not YouTube appropriate. Or Jennifer appropriate. I'm not just gonna be like showing y'all everything. I'm gonna show you without showing you, if that makes sense. So that will probably be in this video. I need to set a reminder to do that. I need to do that probably Monday after I do my Monday or Tuesday. It's not gonna be that far off on this anniversary video situation. So yeah, that's what's gonna happen with that. But I appreciate y'all sticking with me for this whole year. Every week I've been putting out a video consecutively, and I can't believe I've done that. Y'all have been with me, and I've got lots of new subscribers that have stuck with me as well. And I just greatly appreciate every one of y'all. That's why I try my best to answer every one of your comments. Whether it's a question or not, I just want to acknowledge your comment. I see your comments. And so I just feel like I need to take the time to do it. You took the time to write me. I'm going to take the time to write you back. So unless it becomes near impossible, which I don't foresee anytime soon, I'm gonna be writing you back. So go ahead, write me some comments. I will answer you back. It's really nice out here, actually. It's not that bad at all. I am kind of bundled up. I thought I was going to be needing my cloth mask from back in the day. But I like using that for keeping my nose from being so cold. But I'm actually pretty good. I used to be like zip this all the way up, the little fleece thing inside, and then zip this up. If you've been with me since the beginning, y'all know, y'all seen me bundle all the way up. Well, it's bright. But anyway, maybe I'll get to come out of this later on. I did get out the heater in the office. Kind of, it was cool in the office. I feel like it was cooler in there than out here. This ain't bad at all, especially once you get to walking. So get out and walk, people. And that's easier said than done, because I have a perfect neighborhood to walk in, and I haven't been utilizing that. But like I said, and I've been talking about, they're about done with the landscaping. I think it's the last part that they're doing on that house across the street, cutty corner from us. And should be good to go walking, be out of people's way then. So y'all can see me much better now. Got the trees. It's pretty nice because it's all shady in this direction. So I just got a notification that my purse, my coach purse, is gonna be here Tuesday instead of Friday. So y'all might get to see it early after all, before I edit this video. I know you're excited. Happy Sunday morning. I have done been out on my first patrol, and it's colder than a mother bear, because mother bears are cold. Did my nails. These are like a navy blue, as you can see from my jacket here, like that. My husband thought they were black last night when I was trying to show him. I said, they're not black. I do have black, but they're not black. And I trimmed them down so that I can get in here and do what I need to do. So if you're looking for tips and tricks, I don't know if I'm the right person to give you those, but I will try and tell you what I did. Now, I did pull mine off. They were already lifting a little bit, so it was easy to go ahead and lift them. When I was here at work yesterday, I just used a little, what do you call those things? Cuticle pusher, pushes it back. And so I used that, or, you know, like a one of those orange sticks or something like that that you can get up under there with. And got those off gently. It's recommended that you soak them in warm water, like warm water that's sudsy. I can't even talk. But I did not do that. And I had a little buffer pad file that I rubbed across there and got most of the glue and everything off. And then I had some cuticle oil, like gel stuff, almost like a cream. And I put that on there. And then when I got home, I washed my hands real good and did some things to let all that dry. And then I have one of those little things that goes bzz, 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 that you can go around your nails with. It's a nail situation. And I got all around in my cuticle there where there was growth and things. Or growth, not things. And then I got out. I decided on which nails I wanted to use. Got them all out, lay them out, just like do this hand, just lay them out. And I mean, literally fill them up to your hand. And they have numbers on them. If you don't even already know, like Jennifer didn't know before. I had to watch a lot of TikTok videos to get this much information. But the number will be at the end of the nail. So the rounded part, don't do like me and put them on backwards. Put the rounded part right here next to your cuticle, push up in there. So that's why you want to push your cuticles back first, because that's like real estate for your nail to go on. But I use the Dollar Tree basic, $1.25 brush on stuff. I've showed that before. It's the bomb. It's better than what comes with my nails. I'm speaking from personal experience. So these nails are the OPI brand. It came with glue and a file and all that kind of stuff, but I still have my glue and my file at home. Because if one of these pop off, which I don't feel like they will, I will just use the glue I brought with me. That I keep one in my purse, keep one in my work bag, I keep one under the sink at home, I keep a few extras in my little cart that has all my extra nail goodies in it. I stocked up on that Dollar Tree nail stuff after I found out it works really spectacular. But so anyway, once I got my nails on, I do these ones first because I want to use, you want to be able to use your thumb a lot and this finger here to do these last. But I went ahead, and if you don't need them clipped and you're, you know, a womanly woman that can just have real long nails and function, then I guess you don't need to listen to this part. But Jennifer had to start clipping her, so I start clipping like right on the corner on each side, and then I clip in the middle. And if I feel it, if I rub it up and it feels like it's a little bit too long for me, I repeat that process until I get it kind of like shaped the way I want it. So that is how I done my nails, y'all. And I don't know why I went for this color, but it's kind of, does it look too pale on me? I mean, I don't know. I really don't care. It doesn't matter if it is or not. I'm wearing them. And if you get them at TJ Maxx, they're way cheaper, because I saw all the ones like that I already bought at TJ Maxx, they were at Walmart for like $10. And TJ Maxx had them for like $7.99, $6.99, $5.99, that price range. And they had lots of choices. So go to TJ Maxx and hook up in there and see what you can find, because don't be spending extra money that you don't have to. So yeah, I just created me a little variety, and I put them in, organized them and put them in my little drawer situation. I had an extra drawer under where I got my wallets at. I might have showed you all this before. And it's just one of them little rolling carts. And so that's where I have all my little, like, the glue and stuff. Not like other stuff to do my nails. That's actually in my bathroom under the, in my cabinet. But the nails and files and little, the glue is where I wanted to keep them. Because these can actually be reused. I didn't know enough at the time when I was buying all the ones I thought were cool and I liked. But I do have a lot of the ones that also come with the stuff that you don't need the glue. It has some kind of adhesive underneath it. And from what I understand, if you put those on, you need to really make sure you've like used alcohol or something on there and got it, all the oils out of there, because that will create a barrier from the glue sticking. And you also want to not wash your hands either with this or that other kind I'm telling you about. Don't wash your hands for like 3 hours. And the best time to do your nails is at night right before you go to bed, because then they can just be left alone and be dry and they can cure, you know, the glue can do its magic. And then in the morning, then you can do whatever you need to do. So that is how I'm able to leave mine on for as long as I've left them on. It was like 3 weeks. It probably would have been longer if I hadn't messed with them yesterday. But I was just kind of over the pink right now. I know that sounds weird. I love pink so much. But I was wanting just something fresh. So I literally took a pen, and when I did this hand and I laid them off the side, I put an R. And then on my left, for my left one, I put an L. So I know when I saved them, this is what hand those went on, and I can kind of like figure out which nail went on what finger if I want to put those on again. Save your money, people. Don't go give it away to the nail shop, because I mean it's up to you, but I'm just all about, it was fun. It didn't take me long at all. It was once you do this enough, it's like a fast experience. But remember what I was telling y'all about, I had a secret I was keeping from y'all, and then I told y'all about applying for that movie? Here's another one. Here's another secret, but I'm just going to go ahead and tell y'all. I applied for another movie. So, and they're needing people bad over here in the Charlotte, North Carolina area. And it's this new Channing Tatum movie. It's got Kirsten Dunst in it. It's called Roof Man. So, if I get selected for it and I can make the times to go over there and do whatever they need me to do, I will let y'all know. Now, I will tell you, that because I was told for the last movie, you cannot take pictures, you can't take video or anything, because there will be ramifications, especially if you go post it on social media. So, don't expect me to be showing you me with my arm around Channing Tatum or something like that, or shaking hands or, you know, nonsense, because that can't happen. And so anyway, that would be the new secret to tell y'all about, that y'all kind of in on it with me now. So I feel like I can just keep y'all updated if something happens. So if I get a call to go over there, I will go over there and see what happens and let y'all know. Wish me luck. Now, I gotta get back to work now.
Ah! What in the world? Get off my screen.
Happy Mounjaro Monday, everyone. This is going to be like a split video. It will probably say part one, and you will see me do my injection thing this today, and then I'm going to do a separate video, which will be part two of this, showing about my measurements and the changes and all that kind of stuff. And I'm going to try to sift through the pictures that I took of myself, as painful as that's going to be. I'm going to share that with you guys. Y'all have been waiting. A lot of y'all have been with me from day one, since you saw the first video, and haven't left. And I greatly appreciate that. And it makes me want to cry. But anyway, I'm actually going to try to drop the tears. I'm actually going to switch into this shirt. I actually got this at Target on the clearance. And so I kind of matched my watch up with it, which it's not wanting to cooperate right now, but y'all saw what it looked like. But I figured I would not put that sweatshirt on just yet. I'm gonna get back here. Because I'm gonna actually do my arm. It's been a while since I've done the backsides of my arms, and I've been thinking about it, and I really feel like it's time to change up, give my around my stomach time to heal up and all that kind of stuff. I mean, I've not had no itching or anything, so I'm not planning on having itching anymore here. I don't know if maybe I've developed an immunity to not itching anymore, but yeah, that's what's going to happen today. Is I'm going to do this arm here. Where do I want to do with it? A little bit of chubbiness in there. And I'm on 15 still. And also just got that, what that is right there is my prescription for this ready. I have one of these left for next week, but my doctor went ahead and sent in a prescription. And so some of y'all that don't, they're like, how do you do your arm? And, or if you're new here and you don't know, you just act like you're going to reach back here and scratch your back. Put your arm back there. And I'm going to turn it to where y'all can kind of see it pretty good. You ready? Here we go. Oh, let's unlock it. Psych! Okay, here we go. This is for real this time. That hurt. First times I've ever done it, it didn't really hurt, but I know I have lost fat there, but I thought I was getting into the fat Maybe not. And if you just keep using the little alcohol swab and going over it, it helps cool it down and make it to where it doesn't, like, be as painful. So, that is done for the day. And I'll put this back on so I can go put it in our little container thing. And I'm going to switch my clothes. I've got errands to run as per usual. And I know that this part one is going to be long already. So I might as well go ahead and end it now so that I can go ahead and work on part two, because I'm going to upload them both together. You're not going to have to wait, you know, a week for it or anything like that. So you will have a special feature of me. You're welcome. So this is the fit with some jeans and my watch and the face. I've got my navy blue nails on, and yeah, it's says it's 52 out there right now, so I should be okay in this. But yeah, I'm just going to run to the post office and mail off some items I've sold on Mercari and Poshmark. And again, if you're interested in that kind of stuff, the links for that are in the bottom end of the description. Y'all, you'll never believe it. Remember how my Coach purse was supposed to come in tomorrow? Originally Friday, and then they said Tuesday tomorrow. It just got here. Which, you may have already seen it, because I'm going to be uploading a unboxing video. So you may see it before this video. So, in that case, here it is! So yeah, this is her. I love the this handles like this. I'm keeping this one. This is the one I'm in love with. Thumbnail. No. Yeah, the other one had the darker handles. I showed a picture. If you don't remember that, I'll post one right here. But yeah, I'm loving this color better. I don't know if this is like a taupe or beigey color or what it is. I don't know, but I'm just in love with that, with the gold. I just think it makes the gold just pop. Yep. I just wish they would have had this one. That's Bella. She's wanting out. I wish they would have had this in the bigger, large size, and I'd be like, you know, all about that. But anyway, I just thought I would share the good news that I got my bag in this video. Oh yeah, and I do have a matching wallet coming. It's the light khaki, and it's the floral one. It has some pretty like pink and white flowers on it. And I think that'll be just really cute with this bag. But anyway, I can't get over my slippers I'm looking at right now. You want to see? Yep, there's my slippers. So yeah, I'm going to end this here and call this the end of part one, and next is part two. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next half.